Next, let's look at the first basic surgical position, the supine position, sometimes referred to as the horizontal supine position. The supine position is the most common surgical position used. The operating room table is flat, and the patient is lying on their back. A padded arm board may be used, which is attached to the table at the same height of the table. The angle of this arm board should be no greater than 90 degrees. Hyperabduction of the arm greater than 90 degrees or a difference of height may cause injury to the brachial plexus. Supination of the hand on the arm board will rotate the ulnar nerve into a safer position where there is less chance of the nerve being compressed on the arm board. Be aware of staff that may lean on arm boards and cause a compression injury. For patients whose arms must be out on arm boards for long periods of time, slight flexion of the elbow from a wedge under the forearm can help to reduce the stretching of the nerves in the upper extremity. Always check to be sure that the arm boards are well padded. If the arms are to be placed at the patient's sides, the palms should rest against the thighs. When a draw sheet is used to secure the patient's arms at the sides, it is important to tuck the sheet between the patient and the mattress and not between the mattress and the operating tabletop. This decreases the risk of the arms sagging over the sides of the operating table and causing compression of the ulnar nerve or radial nerve. Note that the correct placement of the safety belt is about 2 inches above the knees. Be sure the belt is not too tight as to put undue pressure on the legs. The anesthesiologist is responsible for maintaining the patient's head in alignment. A proper head support will prevent stretching of the neck muscles and maintain the head in a neutral position. A variation of the traditional supine position is the contoured supine position, sometimes known as the lawn chair position. In this position, the hips and knees are flexed slightly, putting the joints in a more neutral position. This helps to relax the lumbar spine and create a more comfortable position for the legs. Patients that are required to lie awake or are sedated and required to be immobile for long periods of time will favor the contoured supine position. Pressure points to be aware of when a patient is in the supine or the contoured supine position include the spinous processes of the thoracic vertebrae, the scapula, olecranon, sacrum, coccyx, calves, and calcaneus. Keep in mind that these areas will receive more pressure than usual and require proper padding when positioning a patient. Always check these pressure points to prevent possible injury.